I know, there's a field of herd of cows there, but I'm being brave. I'm in Clopton Park. Now remember, the Cloptons are in our family down in Suffolk. There's a big hotel there. It's also part of the golf club that was built by a wealthy man who owned all this. But the whole of the, all this estate around here is owned by the Cloptons. Hugh Clopton, you know, William Clopton, possibly related to our Suffolk Cloptons. They're mentioned every now. I've come across this by accident because I wanted to find, I'm very breathless, I've just climbed a big hill, but I've met a woman who's helped me explain things. Now, that, I've been, since I arrived at the campsite, I noticed this obelisk thing, and I thought, I wonder what it is. I've wondered all week, and today, because I didn't do Anne Hathaway's house, I had a couple of hours free, and I walked up the other side of the river, where people have said, oh, you can't go along there. You can. You can go along there. I'm not quite sure where to go from here. I'm just going to follow my way round, I think. So there it is, that obelisk. I'm going to go up to that in a minute. There's a walled garden and somebody's home. Cows wander free here, but this woman said she hasn't had any trouble. But I might give off something cows like, you see. So basically, look at this. This is right near where I'm staying. There's a Clopton house. There's a Clopton tower. And she said, oh, when you've gone up to the obelisk, you can walk along the top and then down through this valley. If you fit up to it, you know. Well, there's nothing else to do at the moment. I don't want... The thing is, the sun's come out and I'm inappropriately dressed. I've got a great big wax jacket on. I've taken my jumper off now. The sun has decided to come out. What I should have done was gone home, topped up with water, because I can see from here, I can see the clubhouse on the site I'm on. See, look, that's the clubhouse there. It's a shame, really, I've got to go tomorrow, because I could actually do with another day here, just to come up here and explore this one properly. This is still all Shakespeare's country, by the way. This is still all Shakespeare's country. What's that? It's a funny stone, look at that. What a thing to find here. That's like a devil's claw. What a find. Put it in your pocket, Sheila. Fancy finding a devil's claw here. That's got to be unique. Very unique. So I'm videoing the obelisk. Obviously there's a house down there. As you see, the cows have been all over. But I want to actually get to the obelisk, because I'm looking forward to taking some photos from that. But you can see this was settlement. This would have been a defensive mound, definitely. I mean, going back to the 11th century with the Cloptons and earlier. I mean, whether the heck, I'll have to look it up. I'm sure I've got a Hugh Clopton in my tree. They were connected to the Pesches. They were connected to the Depeches. At some point, there was a name change. And that's the connection with the Cloptons. Of course, it all seems so unreal to a lot of people I talk to about my tree. They think it's unreal, but it's not. I've done all the work on it. And history writes itself. All the records about them. They keep linking up with other people in my tree. So look at this. I've managed to get to the obelisk. And what a nice evening to do it on. What a lovely ending to do this on as well. You know, what I could do with next time is come in for a week and having the awning up. But you need money. And I've used all the money I had. In fact, I came away, I paid 25 quid. I only had £110. I've had to do all my own cooking. I did buy a ham sandwich. And I have got a can of Coke. I wonder how I get over to the monument then. Hoping you can get through here. Yeah, I expect so. Oh, there it is. Right, I'll just do a bit of video. I'm going to take some photos from here. So this is some monument named after a wealthy man who owned all this land as well, later on after the Cloptons probably. Right, over and out.